Here I am back down fishing, chasing the mulloway again. Today I changed spot. Over here they've been catching it in the Yarra. So I try today. See if I get any. If I don't, I'll go back to my old spot. Yeah, a lot of people been chasing it. No one been landing it. So to show ya, I landed two in 2 days. I'm doing something right, aren't I? Anyway, hopefully I'll get something decent today to show you. You know, like 8-9 kilo. I'm gonna stop it here for a bit. I'm gonna bait up and see what happened tonight. I'm gonna stay too late, probably 3-4 in the morning today. Today, I'm fishing with live mullet again. I reckon it's the best bait. Best bait for mulloway, I don't care what anyone say. You get live mullet and you're in for a chance. After my rod, 2 rod, like usual. And now I'm just waiting for it. This mullet guy, the mullet's a bit weak. I didn't go and catch it today. It is the old mullet. Hopefully it's still alive. Yeah, the mullet's strong now. I think my water's too old. I've got no string to get some water from here. Yeah, the fish last night was 3.4 kilo. That's not bad. Well, I'm waiting for a monster. Look, 20, I don't know, 17, 18. Yeah, with these mulloway, I like to strike it. You know, that's why I'm all the way around my rod. You know, I'll wait. If I see I can strike it, I'll strike it. Sometimes they just take it. You know, you don't have to strike, but sometimes they're just tapping your rod and you've got to see when to strike. You know, if you miss, they'll scare them. They won't come back for a few hours once you make them scared. So you remember, if you think you can strike it and get it, do it. But if you think you can't, let it go. Let it go until it take it. see my lucky jumper, this one. Each time I go mull away, it keeps me warm. And I'll catch. Boy, no way this. But I wash it. The day that I don't go, I wash it. And when you fish for mulloway, don't keep on checking your bait. Just leave it alone, you know? You leave your rod down there. And just, normally, I'll check my mullet. I'll cast it down. I'll give it about 15 to 20 minutes. Then I'll check it. I'll just check it to see if it's still alive. You know? That's all. So if after 20 minutes your mullet's still alive, it's gonna be alive all night. So don't keep on pulling up your rod up and down, you know? It's not like brim or pinky fishing. And you've got to leave your rod alone and just wait.
I'm on again. This is a good one too. This is a good one. Hope it doesn't come off. Oh, this one's a big one. He's running. Oh, he's going in. He's going in the rock. He's coming back out. He jumped. Whoa, he's a big fish. I can see him. He's big. He's big. Keep it for the next. Oh, what a monster. What a monster. Oh. He's a monster. Look at this. Oh. He's a good 15 kilo. Oh. He's a big monster, this one. Even bigger than my brother one. Oh, I'm tired. Here it is. He's a monster. He's a monster, this fish. The one I missed before. Maybe the same size. It ran into the snag, that one. He's a monster, this one. I'm getting my breath back. I'm just filming it so you can see. He's a good meter, 15. Yeah, I'll measure him after when my friend come. If you like my channel, subscribe. Thank you. Yeah, here he is, he's out of the net. He's long. He's long. He's a nice fish. Oh. I'm gonna film it, I'm gonna pick it up. Oh. That's how big it is. See the fish? That's how big it is. Yeah, I'll measure him. He was a meter. 13 centimeter. This thing could be a 15 something kilo. I'll weigh it when I get home.